Now there is an issue with my command line. It is floating around and has been shifted around when I accidentally have dragged it. So there's also an issue with this panel box, which I can accidentally drag away from this fellow and push it in the center. It's floating. I'll try to fix it in that position and hide it, but the command line is pushing out of it. So I'll try to set in the command line again and set it at the bottom. Now, once we have created this position, and we can also drag some of this toolbar, which may be pushed out of this command. Let's say this whole set of commands can be actually accidentally be dragged out of the command bar, something like that, when you accidentally click or drag it. So how do we lock all this? There is a command which is lock UI. If you have used it or type it as lock UI, typically it will be set at 0. Normally, if you have done some research, it will tell you to set it to 1 to lock all the properties or all the lock tools. But unfortunately, it doesn't work. This lock UI 1 is just one of the palette box or windows, but it doesn't lock everything. So there is another icon on the rightmost bottom corner, which is called customization. Here you need to go and set lock UI. Uncheck it and check it. Now an icon will appear here, which is the user interface, which is this with the lock button. Lock user interface. So let's select it. Now, as you can see, when we set the lock UI to 1, it only locks the dock toolbars and panel. The rest, which is the floating toolbars, floating windows and dock windows, are not locked. So let's check all of it, so we can lock everything. Here you can see now it's locked, cannot move. The window, the command line bar, you cannot also move. And these dimensions you cannot move. So that is how to set the lock UI and lock all the menu bars and tools, including the floating dock and panels, into position in AutoCAD.